Well, if your family includes a tween or teen with a smartphone, you need to know about an app called TBH. It's exploded in popularity in recent weeks, with millions of middle and high schoolers now using it every day. But while the app claims to be all about positivity, experts say TBH is one parents need to watch very carefully. On a recent visit to Dixie Heights High School, it didn't take long to spot a kid using TBH, short for To Be Honest. It's a social networking platform and lets users anonymously answer and create polls about classmates. Moderators with TBH must approve those questions, which they claim keeps the content positive. Kids rack up gems if their names are chosen in those polls, but experts say there are some big red flags with this one. Kenton County Commonwealth Attorney Rob Sanders, father of a tween himself, is concerned TBH collects too much personal data from its young users.
First name, last name, age, gender, and school right there is enough for them to find your kid.
Kids can't use the TBH app unless they allow it to access their phone's location and contacts, too. There's also no verification process, so anyone can sign up and claim to attend a certain school, even an adult. And even with the emphasis on positivity, TBH can be used as a tool for bullying. That's because tweens and teens tend to invent their own language of sorts with code words that vary from region to region, even school to school. Those terms can go right over the heads of adults.
I've got a daughter that's 10 years old. Sometimes I can't even understand what she and her friends are saying to one another when they're talking.
Kids also figure out fast how to rig those polls and conspire with friends to stack the results so they can accumulate gems faster. Not bad if you're in the in crowd, but what if your name is never chosen or even included? Experts also worry about a relatively new feature that allows TBH users to message each other.
Just the fact that you can send direct messages anonymous sets up, it's the perfect situation for cyberbullies.
Tara Sides, the Reducing Barriers to Learning director for Kenton County Schools, says they teach students that part of using social media responsibly is owning what you say on it. Posting anonymously runs counter to that. And tweens and teens often don't grasp the true size of their online audience either, something previous generations didn't have to worry about.
Somebody would write something on a bathroom wall and maybe 15 people would see it. Social media is like a bathroom wall, but 100,000 of your closest friends get to see whatever you read.
Part of the reason the apps spread like wildfire is that it collects users' contacts and then scans them to see which kids are already a part of TBH, but it doesn't stop there.
And then it'll send invitations to the ones, to your friends who are not members, so that's one way that grows.
So what do parents need to do? First, keep tabs on which apps your child is downloading from the App Store. Better yet, set up parental controls so you have to approve each app before it's downloaded. And if they already have TBH, talk to them about how they're using it and whether they've seen other kids bullying classmates on it. Rob Sanders says it's important kids understand that an app shouldn't make them feel really good or really bad about themselves.
This is not what you get your own self-worth from. You get this from having good friends and good relationships with good people, not by anything you ever see on the internet or on an iPhone.
If you don't know where to start when it comes to researching some of these hot apps for kids, we've put some important resources online for you on Fox19Now.com. For Fox 19 Now and Simply Money, I'm Mimi Wagner.